Hi there, Darryn Yates here. I am back from Key West. We were there for about a week. I got this hat down there. Hope you like it. I'm very excited, very refreshed. Sorry I didn't do a video last week. It was pretty crazy. My wife probably would have divorced me. I promised her that I would not do a ton of work down there. And this is not like work to me because it's my passion. It's my heart and soul. So it's kind of hard to call it work. And it was so hard to stay away from. But you know what allowed me to clear my head? I want to talk about, what is your message to the world? What is my message to the world? What do I want people to know about me? What do I want to help people with? What is my message? One of my mentors posed that question a few days ago. I know it's a simple enough question, but a lot of people can't answer it. They don't know how to answer it. They maybe never even thought about it. Maybe they think about it all the time. I realized that my message to the world, ignore the resistance. Ignore the hate, the cynical, that negative, insecure thing that comes our way all the time. An amazing percentage of people that just talk negative. They talk crap. They complain. Woe is me. The cynical, the negative, the haters, approximately what is their like average salary versus the average salary of the 100% mentality people who are happy, who are living their passions, living their true talents, doing their true purpose, all the good stuff. It's not even close. The people that are positive and finding a way to make things happen and tapping into their true talents and passions, their salary is head and shoulders above the negative, the cynical, the hateful, the ones who crap on all of our big ambitions. And I realized that that fear of what people thought, or fear of getting hate, or fear of being in a fishbowl where everybody's gonna judge me, that held me back, you guys, for so long. And yeah, I've lived dreams. I've done some cool stuff with my band and my TV show and my radio show I had. But when I met Crystal and started having a family, I thought, you know what? I gotta throw my dreams away, you know? It wasn't financially consistent. Like I said before, I'd get some paydays, I'd coast, get another payday and coast up and down. It was never consistent. So I thought, you know what? There's no way I can do this. I gotta get back in the corporate world, go do a job I hate, go let them soul suck everything out of me, where I'm miserable, I'm a horrible husband, I'm a horrible dad, I don't want to be around anybody. I got stuck in that vicious downward spiral where I finally hit rock bottom in March of 2019. I had a bulging disc in my back. A lot of people tell me that that bulging disc was directly related to my stress, to me not being happy, to me not doing what I really want to do. That eats away at you little by little, and it just tore me apart. But I thought I had to do it, you know? I'm a family guy. I'm married. I got kids. I got to provide. I got to help. And so it was just this horrible situation where I felt just totally trapped. And so when I hit rock bottom, the bulging disc, Crystal was pregnant with kid number 3 with Zayden. I lost the insurance after I got fired, so I couldn't help out with the baby bills. I couldn't get the back surgery I needed. And it was just, you know, just came to a crashing halt. Thank God that happened, because it forced me to find a way to be happy, to find a way to tap into my true talents and passions again, you know? This time around, it was a whole different ballgame. The mindset was 100%, not 80%, or not 75%, or not 50%. I looked for a way only to make it happen, not for a reason to quit. When you burn the boats, you can't take over an island if you got the boats waiting, just in case you can't take it over. You burn those boats, you have to take that island over. That kind of thing. That's what it means to burn the boats. And so I burned the boats. Cool things I've done with the band and all the things, that national acts, the tours and stuff. You know what happened? It was an awesome experience, but I didn't have the mentality like, I'm going to do this no matter what. I'm going to find a way. We just got lucky enough, and it just kind of happened. But then, down the road, when it wasn't happening financially consistently, then I had to get into the corporate world anyway. So the whole point of all that, when you realize that in today's digital online marketing world, you can monetize your talents, your passions, the things you are emotional about, the things you know, the things you think about every day, you can help people with that. Whether you teach them or you help them with mindset or you show them how to do it, whatever. There's ways to monetize your talents, passion. There's an audience for it. There's ways to find them now and to make them happy and help them better their lives, which is what I'm doing. And before I try to help out in all these different areas, but when you just hone in, okay, what does Darryn think about? What is his soul and heart tied to? And since day one, when I first got my garage band, you know, I was a jock. My mom and dad were school teachers. I wasn't supposed to be in a rock and roll band. I was told not to do it. I did it. You know, I was told I can't move to California and pursue my dream of music and rock and roll. I did it. You know, I was told I can't go overseas and tour and all this stuff by all the cynical people. I was told all the stuff given this resistance. I did it. I was told, you know, you can't do radio and TV when I move back home from LA, blah, blah, blah. I did it. Riot Radio. I lost my investor. We had no money. Everything was rolling. So we had to figure out a way to pay for it. I did it. So my whole freaking life, I have been defying the odds. I've been going against the negative, insecure, cynical bullshit. I've been fighting it my whole life. I finally gave into it in March of 2019, and it nearly f***ing killed me. And when I think about that week that I pretended to go to work in complete despair, complete depression, embarrassment, I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to say. I didn't tell Crystal I was fired. I hid. I pretended to go to work and parked in a parking lot. And I researched and I bounced back and I promised myself I would never again succumb to what others might think, the cynical crap. You know, if you don't want to trade places with somebody financially or their life, why listen to them? All the people who give me negative hate and all that insecure, cynical shit, I would never trade places with them. The things I'm working on now, the cats that are mentoring me, they make all those cynical people's salaries in a month. Some a couple weeks, some in one day, some in one webinar. They're making those cynical cats' salaries. They're making those in a one webinar, in one hour webinar. They're making those salaries. And it just so happens that's the way it is. I'm not chasing the dollar. I'm chasing happiness. I'm chasing doing my passion every single motherfucking day. That's what I'm pursuing. And I've always done it. I was never able to consistently monetize it. And I thought, well, I can't do it. It didn't happen. That 80% mindset got me to go back to corporate world and be miserable again. But when your mindset is 100%, you find a way to make it happen, especially in today's digital world. You can make it happen. Back in the day, 15, 20 years ago, whatever, maybe there wasn't a way, you know, because you had gatekeepers that had to let you in to get to the extraordinary life. Now, all those gatekeepers have been just shattered, just obliterated. Is that a word? Yeah. You can make your own success. You can find your audience. You can tap into your true talents and passions and help others and get to that extraordinary life. It's more possible now than ever before. And especially in this crazy world right now, what we're living in, more people are turning to the online world. So there's no better time than now to get into something that's going to make you happy. And yeah, you got to work for it. You got to build it. It's not going to happen overnight. I mean, it happens for some faster than others. There's ways to do it. You can work on a side hustle. You can go all in and quit everything. Go all in with this. That's exciting. That's exciting. And like I said before, money's not the driving factor. If I can make my old salary, heck, if I can make 75% of my old salary in the corporate world doing this, I'll be happy. So it's not about the money. It just so happens people who are doing this, what I'm talking about, they're tapping into their true talents and passions. The ones who are doing this on a high level, they are making freaking bank. But they make the bank because their passion and their talents and their purpose and their calling, it drives the machine. It drives that baby. They scale it. They hire people. It just scales and scales and scales. And it snowballs upward into this beautiful positive thing and just takes off. It's like a tornado of awesomeness. That's just the way it is. There's no ceiling on the salaries you can make in the online marketing world. So my message is for people to say, fuck the negativity. The haters, the cynical bullshit. I can barely talk to anybody in my close circle and a lot of other circles that you know deal with on a day-to-day basis, over the phone, in person, whatever. There's so many cynical people. Most people in this world are cynical, are negative, are not doing anything related to their happiness or passions or true talents. They're not making any kind of money they really want to make. My God, I mean, years ago when I was kind of in that depressed mode, and I hadn't figured it out yet. You know, I was the brunt of some jokes financially and stuff, and now it's like, mofo, I can find a way to make money, especially in today's world. You, my friend, your personality is pretty, you probably can't fix that. But nowadays, you know, if I get it, I have empathy for them. The haters, they need this content more than anybody else, you know, because they're obviously hurting. They're obviously not happy. You know, someone who's doing better than you in life or financially or they're happy or whatever, they'll never come at you. They will always put you up. So remember that. When you get the hate and the cynical people coming at you, remember, people coming at you, they're not doing better than you. They're not doing that well at all. So I encourage my haters to please listen to my content. I want to help you. Now, if you're just observing my content online and you're not interacting, you know, I have a program now that kicks people off. So people on Facebook, if you're not engaging with my stuff, I gotta get rid of you because the algorithm likes engagement and interaction. So the Rock and Roll Life Coach I started out doing after I figured everything out in late March, early April of 2019, that was pretty much me working with artists and helping them with mindset and songwriting and all the digital world of how they can get their songs out on Spotify and get their plays and likes and all that stuff. So that's what it started at. So I changed to Lean In and Dominate because I didn't want to work with just rock and rollers. I love working with rock and rollers. I'm a rock and roller myself, of course, but I want to help out everybody. Anybody who is miserable or not happy knows that they have a message, knows that they have more to give the world. They want to help people. They want to tap into that true passion, that talent, their calling, that purpose, that legacy. You know, taking the simple route, taking the safe route, has never built a legacy. You have to have a little bit of risk. You have to go after it. You have to, you know, resist the resistance. You gotta ignore the resistance. You gotta embrace it. You gotta look forward to it the most. You know, you gotta get into that mindset where bring it on, all the hate, all that crap comes at me, this is part of it. This is part of the game. If I'm not getting hate and resistance, I'm not doing something right, you know what I'm saying? So if it's coming at you, embrace it. You're on the right track. You're gonna lose a few family and friends in your circle. It's okay, charge forward. Make it happen. How bad do you want it, you know? So I am here to help people realize what else is out there. I want to help people tap into their true talents, true passions. True happiness is when you're doing what you love to do. And a byproduct of all that is better money. If you go after the better money, it may not happen. If you go with what your heart and your desires are and your passions and all that stuff, if you go after that, the money will follow. And you'll be able to monetize it more than you've ever imagined. That's the cool part of all this, is that you can do this and be happy. We talk about the entrepreneurs, we work 80 hours to avoid working 40. Yeah, it's a tough, crazy time, but once you get it going, once you get that foundation laid, which I can help you with, you can hire people, and it becomes easier, and you have a better schedule. So it's not going to be easy, but if it was easy, everybody would be doing it, and it wouldn't be as cool. You have to let the happiness vehicle drive this. Be happy. Tap into what you know you love to do, what you know you can help others with or share with, to inspire people or teach them stuff or help them, whatever. As long as you're one step ahead of the people you're helping, you're good. They need you. So people are looking for you. People are waiting for you. So I'm here to help people. Like I said, I've been battling. I've been making things happen my entire life. I keep going. I keep going. I keep going. And I didn't know what the online marketing world was about until I hit rock bottom and was forced to figure it out. It was for survival. It was for happiness. I went to square one. Okay, what of all the jobs I liked? Why did I like them? Jobs I've hated, why did I hate them? What makes me happy? What do I think about every day? What do I do the next day where I look forward to it? And not, oh my God, I don't want to go to bed because I'm going to get up sooner. And I got to go to work. Oh my God, that's not the way to be in life. You don't want to do that. You want to look forward to going to bed. You can't wait to get up. You can't wait to get up and do what you're going to be doing that day because it's your passion. It's exciting. It's the happiness vehicle. It's got to drive this thing. Oprah said, you know, if you figure out a way to help people, you'll never have to worry about money. And like I said, that's not, when I make money comments, I'm just making a point. It's a given, I think, that what drives my train is my happiness to help others, is my happiness to entertain, my desire to entertain, my desire to get my message out to the world. Like I said, I've been fighting this my whole life. The resistance, the negativity, all that crap. So now it's coming at me, and I know it's part of the game. I've researched these mentors. I've researched all these cats killing it. You can too, and you'll figure out that they're doing what they love to do. They're tapping into their true talents and passions. So it's exciting, and I just want to hop on here real quick, let you guys know I'm thinking about you. I'm putting together some programs, some Facebook Live stuff, and you know I am running a business, so I'm trying to come up with the best, craziest, more awesome value than I've ever thought of. And I'm trying to have the price as low as it can go. Stay tuned for that. Please like my Facebook page, at Lean In and Dominate on Facebook. That's my main page. The title of that just Darryn Yates. I want to share this journey. I want to help you guys along. We can all do it together. You know, my goal is to help thousands of people either realize their true talents and passions, find a way to monetize it, or just find a way to be happier. I know I can help you in any of those. Please like the YouTube video, subscribe, all that good stuff. Please tell your friends about it. The first 100 or so subscribers on my YouTube page, man, you guys are gonna be like my VIP people. You guys are all gonna have a special place in my heart. You guys are my first supporters, my first believers in this lean in and dominate thing. Please stay in touch. Please engage with everything. Leave a comment. Tell me what you wanna see. Tell me what you wanna hear. Tell me what topic you want me to go over. You know, I'm doing fun entertainment, and I'm doing mindset, accountability, tapping into your true talents and passions, and resisting, embracing the resistance, the negative, cynical, hateful, insecure stuff that comes at you. You have to embrace it. You have to start liking it and respond to those people with empathy. They're in a tough spot. I've been there, and I've been at the lowest point. I got out. I figured out what people are doing. I figured out how people are monetizing their true talents, passions, calling, all that stuff I keep talking about, to be happy. That's the goal here. And yeah, like I said, a byproduct of that is just better money. And then you got freedom. So I love you guys. Lean in and f***ing dominate. I want to help you all I can. Let's do this. I want to find my people. I want to find my tribe. Let's all rise up together. Thank you.